Andrew McCart, IFL TV, in association with MTK Global. I'm here in Belfast, ahead of Mick Collins' huge fight at the Fela Festival. However, Jamie, the brother of Mick, I don't want to talk about Mick's fight, we'll save that for tomorrow, I'll get another chat with you. I want to get a quick 5 minutes of your time, because I know you're busy, just talking about this news that broke 2 days ago, reference the Golden Contract Tournament MTK have set up. Just break it down for me in simpleton terms, if you can.
Well, it's simple, it's an eight-man tournament, three different weight classes. A bonus incentive of the first, second and third place, whereas even if you get to the semi-finals, you still have something to fight for. If you lose in the semis, there's an incentive and a praise bonus for coming third. So bonuses for knockouts, featherweight, light welter, light heavy. We're looking more than likely at fringe world level. Opportunity for these kind of fighters to break in the world level, they get an even bigger opportunity to fight for world titles. At the minute, we have two former world title challengers, British champion, former world title or former European challenger. So that's only a select few that is already.
There's no point in you saying name them, because you can only say so much, can you?
Well, that's it. All will be revealed in due course. There's still some applications being looked at, because it's globally. This is worldwide invitation to all.
So it's not just select for MTK fighters, it's you want to branch out to other promoters and stuff like that?
No, it's definitely not. No, we're looking to kind of achieve something big, achieve something new, give people opportunities, especially ones who wouldn't have actually have got this opportunity, who didn't have another promoter, didn't have a high-powered promoter to be able to push them in the right direction. Give them the platform to succeed and get on the bigger and better things. For me, the cherry on top of the cake and the real incentive to be in it, to chase it, is the contract at the end, the six-figure contract at the end, and an opportunity for world titles, for big platforms to fight on.
Is that a five-fight deal
at the end, starting figure six figures, starting number six figures.
If that doesn't wet your mouth, then wet your appetite even, what does this?
No, that's the kind of things where it's different. You know, it's not just the tournament, it's what's after the tournament. You're entering the tournament, yes, to make money, you get a knockout bonus, all this here, you can get all different kinds of incomes and whatnot, but the incentive after the tournament to get this big contract, it's unreal. It's like getting on The Voice or the X Factor. When you come through, they get a contract, but the actual experience of The Voice or X Factor, whatever else them things is a bonus in itself. So it's something similar.
What I'm finding quite intriguing about the tournament is, with the World Boxing Super Series, it's almost similar to a bit. There's a few different things to it, i.e. you don't know who you're fighting until a week before your fight, so you can't prepare for a fighter, can you?
That's
the exciting part, I think, fans can get used to.
Exactly. It's added for the fans, added for...
Is it a whole week before the fight, or is it like on the Monday?
It'd be the Monday before the fight, and so it'll be start of the week, we'll do a press arms. And it won't be your normal press, so every show, so it'll either be a Monday or Tuesday of the fight week, every show has a press conference. You ask a question at the press conference, how was training camp, blah, blah, blah. They all give you the same mundane questions, you know, it's the same shit. But with this, it's a press conference, but it's also a reveal of who you're actually fighting. So you're sitting at a press conference and it's going to be finally I'm getting to find out who I'm fighting. So the nerves are kicking in, you know, everything is going. From an outside point of view, you're wondering. But it's like the back of the amateur days, you're waiting for a draw before the competition. You find out the draw at the start of the week, then you fade at the end.
Well, you can't ask how's training camp and you're facing this guy. Well, I never trained for a self-fight.
Exactly,
you know what I mean?
Exactly. So you have to, all areas have recovered. For me, as a fighter, it would be very tough. Mentally and physically, so it's something that all fighters must be aware of going in. It's a tough situation to be in, especially more experienced fighters, not being having that full 8 to 10 week camp to focus on the flaws of certain fighter. You have to actually prepare for the flaws of seven other fighters in the competition and trying to figure out, okay, his strengths, his weaknesses. So it's going to be exciting, it's going to be stressful, it's going to be everything, but it's different, it's unique.
You seem excited,
Jimmy. Very, yeah, from a fighter's point of view, you can't not be excited. It's it's four proper fighters, you know. Opportunities are going to be there for people to enhance their career, to boost their career, to take that next leap in the world level, elite level. But There is the names that I know that is in it. You know it's going to be, there's some quality fights that I'm already in my head. And I think when people get the full eight on each weight, full eight names, they'll be going in their head, oh, I'd love to see him fight him, I'd love to see him. So you have 7 weeks prior to the fight, people, journalists, fans, whatever, fighters, going to myself, I would love to see Andrew McCart fight Coogan, I'd love to see such and such, you know what I mean? Stuff like that there, you go to, this is what it would like. Yeah. But, and then when the draw comes off, some people will be disappointed, some people won't, so it's exciting.
You announced this tournament 2 days ago, and I was looking on Twitter, and it seems like nearly every MTK fighter at the 140-pound division anyway has said, I'll put my name in the hat, so it's already piquing fighters' interest, especially within the MTK stable, hasn't it?
I think I had a few journalists from have got on me, especially Irish journalists who know the Irish scene, have gone on saying the 140 division will be thing. And I wasn't sure if we released it in the press release that 140 is the division. So when they were saying about 140, but everyone has always said, you have enough talent, a pool of talent, that we will be able to do an MTK 140 division. But this is open to others. You know, there is others from non-MTK fighters in the 140-pound division, and it makes it for me a lot more exciting. But
have you proposed this concept to other promoters out there?
I spoke to numerous managers. I spoke to numerous promoters. All very excited. All very interested. And they're throwing us over some names of who they think can fit in each weight division. So I can see some quality matchups. I can see like the odd one or two, the bogeymen and certain ones who not necessarily do tickets, not necessarily are the most attractive, but they're quality operators, yeah. And maybe they're undefeated and stuff like this, so they're going to get an opportunity to come into this. So if you have someone else that you don't want to fight, this, it's stuff like that, all going to be playing up. It's good, it's different, you know, it's not going to be the big thing. So I think we're going to do a reveal when we have everyone locked in. I think we're nearly half done on most.
I'm hearing the first quarterfinal will be October, is that right?
October, November.
November and then February for the semis.
Yeah.
And then we're going into maybe the summer for the
finals. So it's and we're nailed down, I think, on the three cities that we're going to go in.
Edinburgh one?
So we're nailed down on that. We're locking everything down this week while we're dealing with everything else with the feeler. So it's looking.
You're a busy man.
It's busy, very busy, but it's good busy because it's not some boring mundane job that you could not be arsing into. You're excited about the opportunities you're putting on the table for others. You're excited about the opportunities you're giving to the sport. It makes it kind of go like, we're doing something that's pretty good here, you know what I mean? The team that we have around is a quality team. It's a small team, it's a close-knit team, but we're keeping a lot of things moving and changing.
Mm-hmm. Well, one final question. I said I'll only be 5 minutes with you. We're creeping on 10 minutes now. But
I'm sure.
Yeah, it's 10 minutes.
Sometimes I talk and just don't stop.
Sometimes. Yeah. Now, but one final question. I'm guessing it's going to be out on ESPN in the States. Obviously, IFL have been filming the small hall shows here, but I'm guessing you're probably looking for TV out in the UK.
We are in talks with a few different UK broadcasters. So everyone is very excited, and they've been given the proposal of what we have, our format, etc., our timelines and stuff like this, and we're just trying to match it up with a certain broadcaster, and when we have that locked in, that will be a big announcement in the coming week, hopefully.
Good stuff, Jamie. I won't keep you much longer. There's some sort of conference going on, so
nothing to do with us.
Nothing to do with us for a change. I'll grab an interview with you tomorrow if that's all right.
Brilliant. Press conference tomorrow.
And again, thanks for this for TV.
Appreciate it.
Thank you, mate.